That is so fetch.
Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Kaiya, and today we are going to be checking out the daddy, Lorna Shore. I know, Spooner, the time. Lorna Shore is serving us new music this year. I know, aren't we so happy? And they're going to be delivering a full LP in October, and I'm queefing! I'm very excited. So y'all already know Lorna Shore. We've done many reactions of Lorna Shore and Will Ramos. We are going to be covering every single that they release and up until their record, and then we're going to be sitting down and doing the full album. So y'all better be prepared, okay? I'll have the original Lorna Shore video here, or, you know, the latest reaction. Into the Earth is their next one. There's been a few larger metal channels. You probably already know them. I think Alex Hefner is one of them. Yep, Alex Hefner, and then Nick Nocturnal also covered this song already, and they looked very surprised, especially Alex. So I'm very excited. Just by looking at the thumbnail of this video, it looks disturbing as heck. So subscribe to the channel. That's a segue, if you want to. You certainly don't have to, but I post weekly videos. You can join our Discord, the Mosh Pit, down below. There's an invite link. You can also send in your suggestions to the channel email in the description as well. Let me know what you think about this song down below in the comments. And let's get into the Earth by Lorna Shore. Oh, I'm scared. Oh gosh, this looks like a cool record store though. That's me editing my videos. Wow, I want to go to this record store. That's like the ones that you dream about going to. Oh gosh. Where are we? What language is that? Oh God. Yo, I actually really want to shop there. Would y'all be down? Okay. Side note, would y'all be down to like go record store shopping with me if I like did a vlog and like we went and shopped for like metal vinyl and CDs and stuff like that? Let me know in the comments. Oh daddy, daddy, no sirree. No jacket. Dang, girl. He's having a rough time. Really disturbing, but like so cool. Okay, can we talk about double bass and the stops? Delicious. Super good. The main thing I'm noticing is just this music video. I love the filming of it. The different angles, the like creepiness of it, the graininess of it. It's really giving me like old school 80s kind of like Stranger Things vibes. Ooh, giving me like some like old school like horror vibes. This dude's playing this like creepy psycho really well. Damn, look at you, bub. Wow, I can understand him. Damn. Is that what he's saying? Into the eye. Oof. Really creepy face. I'm trying to process what the heck is happening in this music video while also, like, being completely falling in love with the instrumentation of this classic Lorna Shore song. Got beautiful stops, nice big choruses, nice big sound, got the choirs. Lorna Shore has a very, I want to say rude, Lorna Shore has a very particular sound. And I feel like they're one of the bands where if you hear them, you know that that's Lorna Shore. And they're serving the same sort of, it sounds bad by saying they're serving the same formula, but it's not in a bad way. They just have a very specific, they have a sound. And they do kind of the same things in every song. They got the big, like I said, choirs, big sound, reverb, stops. Ooh, this, like, scream that he did. He had, like, one delicious scream just before this. Like, goblin scream. That's what he's so good at. Just to, like, reverb and, like, take up space. They give it the room. Ugh. Little cymbal taps, too, in this section. Love it. Here for it. Alien? chest bursting. Whoa. Is it over? Are you okay, my guy? I bet it's like cursed or something. Yeah! Video. Okay, but like you can't deny that like that would be such a cool. Ooh, I love the font for the Into the Earth. Yeah, this would be I'm getting so many different things. This would be such a cool like 80s throwback sort of horror movie. I also would love if they, like, continued this sort of, like, aesthetic and storyline, maybe, for any other singles that they release, because this is way different than Into the Fire. No, not Into the Fire. I'm sorry. Sun Eater. Because Sun Eater was, you know, an actual music video of just them playing, but this, they obviously aren't even featured in it. very disturbing. Super disturbing music video, but I loved the lows that he delivered in this end were delicious. It's disturbing. It's kind of giving me like some Dracula vibes. I don't know why it's kind of giving me like vampire Lost Boys sort of vibes mixed with like, I don't know, like, The Exorcist or something more, like, just sinister, but, like, old school horror. I really, really like it. It also was giving me, like, The Ring vibes, because he, like, the dude watching it, like, obviously died from it. I really want to go shopping in a record store like that, dude. I love going music shopping, like CDs, records. I love going to bookstores and just like perusing around. For me, this is the most captivating Lorna Shore song out of everything they have released because it went beyond music and became an actual experience. The music is obviously incredible, but the way the video takes you to this sinister, sickening, vile, decrepit place, it really does. I mean, it was almost like alien, like something went into him and then this like woman's hand came out of him, and the actor they used for this music video did a phenomenal job in just in all the weird positions that he was at. That stuff's not easy to do, like all that syncopated, like weird, you know, almost like your limbs are breaking and you're trying to be like this crazy person. That shit's not easy to pull off, at least in my opinion. But I think that the actor did a really good job, and all the like special effects and like weird stuff that they put in it, like the aliens and like the weird like faces that they had, and like, I don't know, it had some really cool things that they were doing. Decrepit place and chains the suspense seamlessly with the music, take this into a entirely different category. You get to the end of the video with that disgusting life form rising out and realize how much suspense, disdain, and tension you've built up over the course of the song. and then it's all released in another horrifically filthy breakdown. Yeah, this is a hard song. This is a heavy track. It's dark. I feel like Into the Earth, we're gonna look at the lyrics, but I feel like Into the Earth is like the guy that was actually in the bed was dying anyway, and so he was like going back into the earth, and so there was like some sort of like demonic entity that was like bringing him back to it. We'll dig more into it. That's at least my first impression. Can't thank you guys enough for keeping real heavy hitting masterfully craft of deathcore alive and evolving. As a metalhead, deathcore hasn't been my go-to genre, but Lorna Shore has been a huge exception as of late. Yeah, they're delivering. They're absolutely delivering. And this is very brutal. And I'm very, very excited to see how their new album is going to sound. So let's go ahead and look up Into the Earth, Lorna Shore. Cover of the single, huh? On Pain Remains. Pain Remains is going to be their 2022 album. Ooh. Is that the album cover they're sticking with? I would have thought, I hope they change it. Not gonna lie, I'll just keep it OG with y'all. I hope they change the album cover, because that's a little tame for what we just saw, honestly. And it's also a little tame for, like, the, I feel like the EPs, oh, their EP album cover was, like, so sick nasty with that floating orange Grim Reaper. That was such a sick album cover. Sick album cover. So this is a little tame, in my opinion. So I hope that, I mean, it's probably going to be the one, but maybe they'll do something different. Produced by Josh Schneider, written by Lorna Shore and Will Ramos. I like that they get put Will Ramos separate from Lorna Shore. Century Media. Lead guitar drums. Random Awesome Studio. That's where they recorded it from. Nothing about this track. It did just come out a couple days ago, so. Sensation leaves as I'm drifting slowly. Illusions torn from my splintered veins. Reality shifts like pages turning in the wind. I'll become the sun. I'll become a god. I'll become the dreamer, dreaming frozen in my anxious mind. Feeling slowly fades into plasticity. Is this the end or just the beginning? Lucidity or nightmare unfolding? The chorus, my heart, my soul, my body has grown so cold, converge, I crash into the earth, ooh. Into the earth, lost in the scape, terrified, break me fear, break me free from this nightmare, stifled by realms uncertain, I can't escape, let me go, I'm fucking horrified, now all my fears are personified. Yeah, I actually was able to understand him in this, like, Into the Earth part, which is cool. Because I feel like for Will's vocals in Lorna Shore, I have a hard time understanding, like, what he's saying. Because it's just, it's deathcore, it's different, you know? But I'm getting there. I'm learning it, so. This song slapped. I'm hoping that we can at least get some notes on it eventually. But I understand that it's like still brand new. It's only 3 days old as of the time that I'm filming this. So let me know down below in the comments what you thought about this song. Did it slap? Did you like the music video? And is it better or worse or on par with Sun Eater in your opinion? Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and for hanging out with me today. I really appreciate it. We hit 5K subscribers, y'all. I know. way ahead of that by the time that you're seeing this video, but we hit 5K, so we've got some special things that are happening on the channel. So if you want to subscribe and join the mosh pit, do so. What are you waiting for? No pressure, though, also. So I'll see you soon, wherever you are, whenever you're watching this. Take care and enjoy the rest of your time.